वेलकम टू रुचा चैनल. आई हैव टोल्ड यू इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू कनेक्ट फ्रॉम माई होम इट्स सेल्फ नाव डेज. फॉर मी इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल टू विजिट द कॉलेज एंड ऑल इशूज आर देयर. सो आई हैव मेड वन बोर्ड ओवर हियर, सम एडजस्टमेंट आई हैव डन ओवर हियर सो दैट आई कैन कनेक्ट यू फ्रॉम माई होम इट्स सेल्फ. आई होप यू वुड लाइक दिस एंड आई एम गोइंग टू ट्राई फॉर मोर. सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन अबाउट इकोनॉमिक्स. So now it is totally over. The chapter has been over and I hope you have understood about it. In this session, we are going to see something about animal science. So today it's 28th July, guys. Tuesday, we are meeting with Ichitar. And I'm going to talking about agricultural biotechnology. This is course number AS233 and the credits are 3, 2+1. Okay. And the name of the course title will be Livestock Production and Management. I hope you are able to see me properly and all. So your course title will be Livestock Production and Management. Okay. So this is our course title. Nextly, what we are going to see in this. Firstly, let me give you some introduction about what is animal science. So basically, what is important in animal science, that I'll tell you. You are studying all about animals. What is the importance of animals or what we get from animals in different countries? Not about only India, we are going to study about all countries. Scientific names of animals. What things they offer to us, what precautions should be taken while keeping these animals with us, some domestic animals, some wild animals, all this we are going to study in this session, guys. So firstly, while studying introduction, what comes is you have to see importance of livestock. In that you will classify it into three eras, Vedic, medieval period and the modern period. So I'll mention it like that. While studying the livestock, you are basically going to see it into three sessions. That is Vedic, means in the ancient period, what was the importance of animals? I hope you are able to see this. In Vedic period, secondly, in the medieval period, and thirdly, we are going to see about the modern era. What is the importance in all these stages that we are going to see? So, discussing about the word livestock, it's very necessary to understand what is the meaning of the word livestock, guys. Okay. So, livestock is commonly defined as domesticated animals raised in an agricultural setting to produce labor and commodities such as meat, eggs, milk, fur, leather and wool. Everybody knows that animals offer us something. Fur may be there, wool will be there. From wool, what things we do? We make clothes and everything is being done. Eggs are there. These eggs are being consumed by us. That is very beneficial because it is a proteinaceous substance. If you take example of milk, it gives us calcium. There we prepare many different milk products also. Meat is there, that also we consume. So these are all the things that animals offer to us. So definitely animals are beneficial to us, guys. So, talking about that thing, sometimes this consideration is been taken into two types. Means once you can classify it as only for consumption, used only for consumption, and secondly for farm ruminants. Now, what is the example of farm ruminants and example of consumption? I'll tell you very properly. So, when you're talking about consumption, let us take example of a sheep. So, sheep will give you some products. Okay. So these products you are going to consume, you are going to take it. Consume means what? You are going to utilize. Wool is there, leather is there, these things. Okay. Nextly, if you take example cattle, what will cattle give you? It will offer you milk and all this. And this you can utilize or consume in your day-to-day life. When you are taking example of, I told you, farm ruminants. So what is the meaning of what farm ruminants? Animals which you keep as domesticated animals. The example of domesticated animals will be sheep, goats, cattle. You keep them for your farming purpose also. So they are beneficial in both sides. One for consumption and another one is for other benefits. Okay. So if you talk about USA country, United States of America, their horses are been considered as a proper livestock. What is the reason? All I am going to explain you in detail. According to USDA, it classifies your pork. Pork is the outer covering which you get from pig. Okay. So that is the lamb is there. These are all considered as meats and these are called as red meats. This is something general introduction. In the next lecture, we'll